Welcome back to the IBSP. Here's your host, Foxy New.
Welcome back, Fight fans. Welcome back. Let's just dig right into it. Golden Boy has sent over an offer to the PBC to make the Ryan Garcia versus Tank Davis fight in December 2020. And this is according to the Chris Mannix podcast. You know, that's where they stated this information. And, you know, Golden Boy, Oscar De La Hoya have enormous, you know, trust in Ryan Garcia to be ready for a guy like Tank Davis. A Tank Davis where many people thought is leaps and bounds ahead of Ryan Garcia. But that's nonsense. Obviously, if you see one fighter like Ryan Garcia continuing to ascend, while you see a guy like Tank Davis who has a myriad of problems descend, you know, regress, while, you know, Ryan Garcia continues to progress. And, you know, we see that inside and outside of the ring. And we start, you know, with one of the first reasons why we believe that is you see Tank Davis, you know, up against his, you know, moving up in weight, up against one of his I guess notably best opponents, according to him, was a Euriorkis Gamboa, a 40-year-old fighter who's been dropped over 14 plus times, a very chinny Gamboa who's been knocked out before. And, you know, Tank Davis comes into this fight on the eve of that fight, and he literally misses the weight on his first attempt. Who misses weight on the first time, you know, weighing in, moving up in weight? You moved up in weight so you wouldn't struggle to make weight. It makes no sense. And, you know, this isn't a new pattern for Tank Davis. This is something that he's already done in 2017 against, you know, Francisco Fonseca. He missed weight entirely and forfeited the IBF world title. So, you know, Gervonta Tank Davis has already shown a history of being undisciplined. That's why I favor Ryan Garcia in any bout against Tank Davis. But not only that, you know, we also look at his performances in the ring as well. You know, you see his performance against a Euriorkis Gamboa, a 40-year-old chinny fighter, a guy who's been dropped over 14 times, who's already been knocked out before. And you know, the interesting thing is he sustained a grade 3 Achilles tear in the second round of his fight with Gervonta Cheeseburger Davis, and he went to full 12 rounds. It makes no sense. You got to get the guy out of there who's already chinny. You got to be able to cut off the ring. You got to be able to do it. But, you know, a lot of people made a lot of excuses for Tank Davis. It's simply that he's not disciplined. It's simply that he's not the fighter that people hyped him up to be. This guy is 25 years old. Ryan Garcia is 21, so anybody comparing the accolades of the two makes no sense. Ryan Garcia is moving in as a contender, while Tank Davis already was a champion. You got to be honest and unbiased. And now when you look at a similar opponent in the two, a mutual opponent in Francisco Fonseca, you see that Tank Davis struggled with him at times and took him 8 rounds to get him out of there. And when you look at a guy like Ryan Garcia, he literally stopped and demolished him in the first round. Let's be honest. You know, you see the differential in Ryan Garcia and Tank Davis. And one of the most stunning differences is that Ryan Garcia is 5'10" with a 70-inch reach, while Tank Davis is 5'5.5" with a 67.5-inch reach. Simply off of height and a reach alone, that's going to be a difficult fight for Tank Davis. Because not only does Ryan Garcia has, you know, very fast hands, he also has an enormous height and reach advantage over the smaller Davis. And he's much more disciplined. He doesn't have these weight issues coming into the ring. You gotta be honest and unbiased. And then, you know, you also see one of the biggest reasons why I would pick Ryan Garcia to beat Gervonta Cheeseburger Davis right now is simply because of Eddie Reynoso, the best trainer in the world right now, the guy who's training Canelo Alvarez, the guy who's training Oscar Valdez. You know, Eddie Reynoso is one of the best trainers in the world, and he's been proving that time and time again, year and year again. And the huge leaps that he's made with Ryan Garcia defensively have been enormous. And you know what? That is going to be one of the main reasons why I believe Ryan Garcia beats Tank Davis. And you know, not only that, you know, Ryan Garcia has one of the biggest step up fights of his career coming, the biggest actually, in Jorge Linares next. And you know, that makes a lot of sense. You know, if Ryan Garcia goes in and beats a Jorge Linares, this is an opponent that's literally better than everyone Tank Davis has fought up to winning the title. So you got to be honest and unbiased. Ryan Garcia is already making huge strides. The fact that he wants to take on Tank Davis by the end of the fiscal year 2020 shows that he truly wants to be great. But once again, unbiased as always is the IBFP.